Good evening. Welcome to Grandma's Attic Music Review. It's so good to be with you tonight. Ah, so much is going on, right? Right? The hygienic Salon de Independence starts tonight. And you might be home from that starting by now and ready for some beautiful music to just relax you into your slumber. But you're not going to want to sleep for the next hour because we have for you probably the I'm not even going to try to be a smartass. Probably the duo that does the best at bringing to you the best of covers that plays anywhere in the New London County area and beyond. They've been playing together for a while. They've been together on my show several times now. I think maybe three or four times easily. And they just always bring love and joy and great music to the show. So I want you to sit back and relax and see what they have for you tonight. I think you'll be able to sing along to a couple. I think you'll get some of those good old groovy feelings from some of these songs. And I really hope that you will welcome into your heart and into your home, FRANKENPHIL. Thank you.
walls for the first time. You understand how I came this way. Cause the truth you might be running from is so small, but it's as big as promise, the promise of the coming day. So I'm searching for tomorrow, my dreams are dying, and my love is hanging tight, dear, tied with a silver chain. I've my ship, all the flags are flying. She is all that I have left. Music is her name.
Figured with the passing of David Crosby, we would do a few songs from the CSN.
As it should be.
We're going to move on to a Dylan thing. Lay, lady, lay, I lay across my big brass bed. Lay, lady, lay, I lay across my big brass bed. Whatever colors you have in your mind, show them to you and you'll see them shine. Lay, 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 lay across my big brass bed. Stay, lady, stay, stay with your man you are. Till the break of day, let me see you begin smile. His clothes are dirty, but his hands are clean, and you're the best thing that he's ever seen. Stay, let him stay, stay with you, man. Before your world to begin, you can have your cake and eat it too. When a man go for the one you love, when he's standing in front of you. Thank you.
Something by the band. Two, oh, 1, 2, 3, 4. Get up, Jake. Late in the morning, the rain is pouring. We got work to do. Get up, Jake. No need. Tell me that you're dying, but I know it's not true. Me and Jake were down by the river on the fair at Baltimore. When Jake don't rise up in the morning, people line up all along the shore. Get up, Jake, late in the morning, the rain is pouring, we got work to do. Get up, Jake, no need to lie, but tell me that you're dying.
Thank you. something by Willie Nelson. Too close to the ground. I patched up your broken wing, hung around for a while, trying to keep your spirits up and your fever down. I knew someday that you would fly away. Love to find its healer to be found. Believe me if you need to, I will still remember. Angel, find you close to the ground.
Maybe he just sings it different.
Well, he probably does. We kind of.
I just don't remember that song. I love that song. I just don't think I've ever heard it before. Or maybe I haven't. Just it didn't strike a chord with you. It's a beautiful song.
Thank you.
You can do that again on my show anytime you want. Come sing it in my backyard this summer.
Took a look down a westbound road right away. I made my choice. Headed out to my big two-wheeler. I was tired of my own voice. Took a beat on the northern plains. I just laid that power on. Well, I was out of Mackinac City, stopped in a bar to have a brew. Met a girl, I had a few drinks, I told what I decided to do. She looked out the window for a long, long moment, and then she looked into my eyes to say a thing. I knew what she was thinking, roll, roll. Roll me away, won't you roll me away tonight? I feel the ball crossed, I'm tired of what's wrong and what's right.
never even said a word. We just walked down and got on that bike and we rode. We're all clean outside. We rolled across the high plains, deep into the mountains. It felt so good to me, finally feeling free. Somewhere on the high road, the M began to turn cold. She said she missed her home, had it all alone. I stood alone on a mountain top, staring out at the great divide. I could go east, I could go west, all up to me to decide. Then I saw a young heart flying, and my soul began to rise. And pretty soon, my heart was singing, roll, roll, roll me away. Won't you roll me away tonight? Gotta keep rolling, I keep on riding, keep on searching till I find what's right. At the sun I faded, I spoke to the nearest faint starlight. I said next time, next time we'll get it right. Roll me away tonight. Roll me away tonight. Pretty obscure tune. Came off of a soundtrack. The movie was called The Wonder Boys. Michael Douglas. Worried man with a worried mind, nothing in front of me and nothing behind. There's a woman in my lap and she's drinking champagne. Got white skin, got assassin's eyes. Well, I'm looking up into the sci-fi tinted skies. Well, I'm well dressed and I'm waiting on the last train. Standing on the gallows with my head in the news. Any second now, expecting all hell to break loose. People are crazy and times are strange. I'm locked in tight, I'm out of range. Well, I used to care, but things have changed. Thank you.
This place ain't doing me any good. I'm in the wrong town. I should be in Hollywood. Just for a second there, I thought I saw something move. Gonna take dancing lessons, do the jitterbug rag. Ain't no shortcuts, I'm gonna dress in drag. Only a fool you would think he's got anything to prove. A lot of water under the bridge, a lot of other stuff too. Don't get up, gentlemen, I'm only passing through. People are crazy and times are strange. I'm locked and tied, I'm out of range. Well, I used to care, things have changed. I've been walking 40 miles of bad road. If the Bible's right, the world's gonna explode. I've been trying to get as far away from myself as I can. Some things are too hard to touch. The human mind can only take so much. What you can win with a losing hand. Be like falling in love with a first woman I meet. Putting a wheelbarrow, a wheeling it down the street. People are crazy and times are strange. I'm locked and tied, I'm out of range. Well, I used to care, things have changed. Just don't show it. You can hurt someone and not even know it. The next 6 seconds could seem like an eternity. Gonna get low down, gonna fly high. All the words in the world add up to one big lie. Well, I'm in love with a woman who don't even appeal to me. Mr. Jiggs and Miss Lucy, they jumped in the lake. Well, I'm not that eager to make that same kind of mistake. People are crazy and times are strange. I'm locked and tied, I'm out of range. Well, I used to care, things had changed. People are crazy and times are strange. I'm locked and tied, I'm out of range. Well, I used to care, things have changed. Oh, well, I used to care, things have changed. Oh, well, I used to care, things have changed.
I show you won't.
Have you changed your style? don't seem the same. Seems you've lost your fear for me. So then leave him alone. But we don't see how to
guys want to do one more song and then come talk to me?
All right. Everybody's gone away. Say they're moving to LA. Not a soul I know around. Everybody's leaving town. Some caught a freight, some caught a plane. Find the sunshine, leave the rain. They say this town will waste your time. I guess they're right, it's wasting mine. Some gotta win, some gotta lose. Good time Charlie's got the blues. You know, my heart keeps telling me you're not a kid at 63. You fool around, you lose your wife. You fool too long, you lose your life. I got my pills to ease the pain. Can't find a thing to stop her. You know, I'd like to settle down. Every
everybody's leaving town. Some gotta win, some gotta lose. Good Time Charlie's got the blues. Everybody's going away. Say they're moving to LA. Not a soul I know around. Everybody's leaving town. Some caught a freight, some caught a plane. Find the sunshine, leave the rain. You know I'd like to settle down. Everybody's leaving town. Some gotta win, some gotta lose. Good Time Charlie's got the blues. Some gotta win, some gotta lose. Good Time Charlie's got the blues. Some gotta win, some gotta lose.
Nicely done, gentlemen. Come on over and mic up. While they're putting down their instruments and miking up over here, it is the middle of the winter, and it is time for the Hygienic Salon d'Independance. No judge, no jury, one piece entered in the show. I hope that you got a piece into the show. Mine's down there. I'm not going to tell you where it's hung. See if you can find it. It's got kind of an iconic title. So check that out. This is the time of year when there's arts and music all over town, all night. Like, just, it's an amazing time of year. This has been going on since back in the 80s. So if you've never been a part of the Hygienic Salon d'Independance, get out there and celebrate. There's art, there's music, there's big art and little art. There's a grand show that's up at RD 86 that's being curated by Bill Dumas, so check that out. As you may know, last night was the Hoop for Hunger. There's some other things going on. You can check it out on the Hygienic website. So great music, great art, support local artists, and get out there and celebrate this time of year. Warm yourself up with some love of local art. Hi, guys.
Hello.
Let me turn around here.
How's it going?
Welcome back.
Thanks for having us.
So I posted some pictures of you guys up on Facebook, like while you were playing, and somebody chimed right in. I just saw these guys a couple weeks ago up in, I don't know, so you were at the other side of the state.
Yeah.
You guys get around.
Yeah, we do.
Where did you play last?
We played at the place in town here.
Oh, where did you play out of town last?
Well, he's the guy with the
Yeah, I can't remember anymore, though.
Put us on the spot.
Just got me down.
I don't know. We played up in, it's been a slow time of year for us. Actually, we've been busy a lot other times. But grab my phone, Frank. We'll look it up.
I can find it. It's not important.
Yeah.
I guess what is important is where are you playing next? And when can people find you? How do they find you? Let's look, and then we're going to talk about your history.
Well, we have a website, frankenphil.com.
Okay.
And Frank keeps that up to date. Always, the calendar is always right on. So.
Yeah, he's pretty spot on when it comes to promotion. You guys are well promoted. Thanks, Frank.
Okay, so Saturday, February 4th.
Okay.
A little bit of a gap.
Not much.
Saturday,
next
February
weekend.
4th. Saturday, February 4th, we're at New Harvest Coffee and Spirits. That's in Providence. That's one of our residencies. We're there,
oh, wow.
We're there the first Saturday of every month ongoing. So
nice.
That's every single month. And
nice.
Then Sunday, February 5th, we're at Scotch Plains Tavern in Essex. Which
oh, that's a nice place.
Which used to be Oliver's.
Right.
And we're there the first Sunday of every month. We usually play 4 to 7, but that day we're actually playing 1 to 4.
I think that my sister is part of that whole place out there.
Oh, oh great.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. So I'll tell her to yeah. give you guys a shout when she sees you there.
Excellent.
So that's cool.
Well, now the New Harvest Coffee spot in Providence actually bears a little more discussion.
Okay.
This neighborhood, which is Olneyville, O-L-N-Y,
okay.
which was kind of an industrial sort of neighborhood, is, I don't know if gentrified is the right word, but there's some folks doing some pretty interesting stuff over there. The building we play in is a prefab. It's a large prefab metal building, which houses not only New Harvest, but Providence Brewing Company. They have the farmer's market down there.
Oh, nice.
On Saturday mornings. And there's a taqueria there across the street. There's a brewery. There's a distillery in the neighborhood. Lots of young...
Lots of booze going on in that hood.
Absolutely.
And as you approach, it's kind of funky to get there now, but they're putting in new highways, a lot of construction. So it appears as though this neighborhood in the future is going to really get bumped up because you can see the new... And for at this time of year, for to get out of the house, a little adventure, something to do, it might be something people would consider, even though it's a bit of a drive, but I mean...
Providence isn't that much of a drive.
No. But I'm just saying that people in this time of year have been cooped up for so long.
Right.
And great, it's so even though you're not sure what you're going to get into, sometimes you just want to go on an
where
adventure.
Are you playing, do they serve food?
Yeah.
And what kind of food?
Well, New Harvest has its own selection of coffees and spirits, actually, and snacks.
Okay.
And then the farmer's market is there, so there's all kinds of folks selling baked goods and fresh stuff. And
nice.
And like I said, the taqueria is right there. I mean, it's all together. It's a pretty hip scene, I mean, I've got to say. It's
nice.
Pretty cool. A lot of
nice.
Young hip folks and pretty nice.
How did you get yourself into that residency, Phil? I mean, Frank. You had to pull some strings. I know you did.
Well, we actually played... in the summer of 21, we played
okay.
for the farmer's market, which is also, basically that building is Farm Fresh, and that's just a big affiliation, and that's why there's all these other businesses in there.
Okay.
So we played for them, and where we played was outside back in June of 2021,
mm-hmm.
and New Harvest Coffee was set up right next to us, and the gentleman, Ryan, talked to us. He really liked what we were doing, and he was like, we'd like to work something out with you sometime soon. So by the end of July, I think it was 2 days after my birthday, so like the 29th, Thursday the 29th, we were already playing at New Harvest, and we just played there once a month from that point forward. Keep in mind, that gig is generally a morning show in the wintertime, so we start at 11 a.m.
Oh, nice.
And then in the summertime, it kind of switches. Sometimes we play outside, and it'll be more of an afternoon thing at, like, you know, mid-afternoon or early evening. And it's usually just a two-hour window. But it's been really great, and the response is really great there. We can, you know, have a very nice, mellow coffee house vibe, and it's just very special.
So nice. Meanwhile, the guy from Providence Brewing Company, which is in the same building, gets his coffee at New Harvest.
Okay.
So he walks by us.
That's an open door.
Yeah.
And he sees us and says, hey, guys.
Come play at my place.
Come play at my place. So we do that. That's pretty cool, too. And there's also a flea market in the... So
those are on Sundays.
Those are on Sundays.
Wow.
And it's a... I mean,
what's going on up there?
Yeah.
Just in that one building.
Yeah. Lots
wow.
of interesting people, yeah. And... So, yeah, that's working out pretty well.
And you guys get around in the state of Connecticut, too. You've played over in Mystic. You've played in Meriden. You've played in New London. I don't think I know of a place that you haven't played at. What makes you look for a place to play, and what draws you to certain places?
Well, Frank does all the booking, so he's got his own approach. But I could say that we're looking for places where we fit. And then that's not every place, you know. It might be a rock club, but we're not that kind of an act, you know.
Right.
But we like to feel the ambiance of the room.
Exactly.
And match it, kind of, add to that feeling.
Yeah.
We don't want to hijack what's going on. We sort of want to, and we want everyone to be comfortable.
Right.
So.
Enhance the vibe.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. So pretty much that's kind of what we look for. We look for similar acts and how they're doing and where they're playing, and sometimes mm-hmm. track what they're doing and say, well, that seems like an interesting spot where they're playing. You might pop in, see what the place is like, or check them out online. And I must say this, I have musician friends who have done the same thing, of seeing where we're playing.
Right.
And say, ah.
If they're playing there, maybe we can get in there.
Right.
That's awesome.
But the thing with booking the venues is that it ends up being very organic. It has to work both ways, and it has to be kind of a mutual relationship, because that's how it becomes a success.
Right.
Ryan saw us, for instance, at New Harvest, who really liked what we did, and then Efren saw us from Providence Brewing Company, and now we're connected with these folks like all the time, you know, once a month, twice a month, and that's what we look for. I mean, we play music because we absolutely love it and have been doing it for so long, and we want to make sure that we have consistency and longevity wherever we go.
So that was going to be my next question. Nice segue, Frank. How long have you guys been playing together? And let's talk about that first, and then we're going to get into a little bit more history.
So almost 10 years, actually. Well, it'll be 10 years in July that Phil and I first started performing together.
Wait, we did
it was actually end of June, actually, of 2013.
We did the Garlic Festival, and Mystic was our first gig.
And did Richard book you to that?
Yes, he did, yeah.
He's amazing.
But he booked me as a solo. The interesting thing that I was playing with another bass player, Chuck Davis, as a matter mm-hmm. of fact, who plays with American Honey.
Yep.
Great guy, great
I
bass
know,
player.
I know who
man.
It is.
So he was doing a thing in Boston. He was trying to make a time of my gigs and this and that. And he has a voiceover business. So but basically, he needed some space. So he had to move on. So I was back doing some solos. And Frank was working with a singer that decided to move on. So he was stuck needing a singer.
Yep.
And I was stuck needing a bass player.
And we both had gigs booked.
We had both had gigs that day. He had booked, he said, I need someone for tonight. I said, well, come over to this Garlic Fest, sit in with me.
Yep.
And just because I've got enough songs to do it. And we'll just go to the, so that afternoon we played one gig, we took a break, went home, freshened up, and went off to the second gig. First time we ever played together, no rehearsals.
Wow, how'd that work out?
It worked out well, yeah.
It worked out well, and here we are.
Did you both have like the same kind of repertoire when it came to songs?
Yeah, I was familiar with what he was doing because we would run into each other at different gigs. He'd sat to mine or I'd see him. So we pretty much knew that was the case already. We call it our wheelhouse, what fits in our wheelhouse. So that's, you know.
And it worked. No thoughts in the future of ending this
oh, not at all,
this
no.
team. This is a good team.
No. Yeah, not
this
at all.
This is a good team. You've been doing it quite a while. And you seem to draw in crowds that, obviously from the comments on Facebook, that really enjoy what you're doing. So that's a lot of fun. I have to tell you, Frank, your smile on the camera is enticing. That's if that's a word.
Yeah, it is.
It is a word, but I'm wondering if you guys are doing well enough to only do this, and if not, then what are you doing to make a living, especially with COVID not going away yet?
Well, Phil's retired.
Nice.
He retired from Foxwoods back in 2018. And, you know, so previous to that, in 2015 and 2016, we were playing a lot. And I had to kind of pull back the booking because Phil was still working, you know, 40 hours a week. So I couldn't, you know, I didn't want to like overwhelm him. So, but when, you know, we had the intention that, you know, if we were still playing together when he retired, which ended up being in April of 2018, that we would just start ramping back up. And we So 18, 19, we're ramping back up, then COVID.
Yeah. Right.
Then, you know, that whole thing, we can only play outside during the summer of 2020. But by 21, I mean, June through October, we did over 70 shows. This past past season.
That's impressive.
This past season, just in a 5-month window, and then this past season from June through October, it was the same. I mean, it was 70 plus shows. I mean, you know, pretty insane, you know. We're really
That's
grateful.
That's pretty good.
Yeah. And we did like the Waterford Beach Summer Concert Series, and we're just trying to do more things where we get more visibility, more connection with people, and, you know, just making new friends. And traveling
just for the
places.
Record, this show doesn't hurt that.
Oh, I know.
This show doesn't hurt that. I think, I may be wrong, but I doubt it. I think that your shows that you've done here are the most viewed shows on YouTube that we have.
Really?
Except for Lucas.
Oh, Lucas Neal, have you met him yet?
I have not, no.
Oh, my gosh. Lucas Neal is about 10. Not really. I think he might be 25, maybe? He's young. But he's brilliant. He's brilliant. And he's writing his own stuff, and he has some ultra huge devoted fans.
That's great.
So, yeah. So, anyway, but I know that your segments on this show are highly highly viewed.
Oh, great. That's great. I didn't know
and that.
That
means you've got some
Thank
followers
you.
Yeah, yeah. that
Thank you,
really
people.
Want to see. Well, I think a little bit of your promotion prowess comes into play there. I think that you let people know that you're out there and that it's.
I post the link when it's available, and I show people, and you know, say, hey.
And people are on it. People are on it. What do you think people want to hear from you guys? Why do you think that they like hearing you doing covers so much?
Well, first of all, it's a fairly wide demographic.
Right.
Drawing off of my list and my age group, which luckily is still loved by even younger people. People ask what kind of music it is, what style it is. But I do everything from, we could do Ray Charles to George Jones. I mean,
you really do touch on all the classics.
So I think that's one reason why, because different age groups can all appreciate it. Not by design, really, but just because it's the music we love, you know?
Right.
Absolutely.
And my, you know, the choice of how to choose a song isn't as much about style, like is it country, is it rock and roll, is it, it's more about how it affects you.
Feeling.
Your feeling, how it makes you feel. And I think that's pretty close to what it's what. And not exactly the same topic, but I recall an interview with Bonnie Raitt, and one comment she made that struck me was, I was lucky enough to choose a music that allowed me to grow old gracefully while playing this music. And I think that's an important thing as well. It's still good. It's like, what music never goes out of style, you know? I mean,
good music. Let me answer that question for you. Good music. I was just looking at a list of musicians that are still with us. Older musicians, people from, I think the youngest person they put was Stevie Wonder, and he's 73.
Yeah.
Wow.
That was the youngest person on this list, and it was like a hundred person list of famous musicians, and they're all still performing.
Yeah.
Wow. What's that say? Yeah. And
a lot.
None of the people that have passed in the last few months, even. I mean, I think of David Crosby and how he was just here at the Guard. I think it was 2 years ago. Yeah. Not even.
He was planning a tour.
He was. Yeah. And he would have played. He did. He played till he died.
Yeah.
And brought music to
King.
All, yep, absolutely, oh absolutely. And so many people that we grew up with, you know, most of them older than me, but not by much, you know, that we watch have changed our lives because of a little piece of a little song.
Yeah.
something that they sang to us. So when you, I have to tell you, when you did Good Time Charlie's Got the Blues, Goodbye Charlie, what is it?
Good Time Charlie.
Yeah.
Yep.
I teared up. Oh. That song has roots with me that go way back.
Yeah.
Right? And right. You started playing it. I started singing it. I got tears coming down my face. And that's why we love having you guys come here, because you bring the songs to us that changed our lives then and still affect us today.
Sure.
So wonderful. Thank you so much for doing that. Thank you so much for coming back to the attic. I'd like to ask you if you would take us out with a song.
Sure.
Yes.
We'd like that very, very much. This will be posted up on YouTube Sunday morning. And I hope that people go to the Hygienic Art Show earlier tonight, and come home and watch this show, because it will be wonderful. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Get ready and go take us out with a song. And here we are. Guys, thank you so much for tuning in to Grandma's Attic Music Review. The ratings, if there are such a thing, for public access TV have gone up there. You guys are watching this show and sending me your appreciation, watching on YouTube. I try to bring you the best music I can find. I try to bring you music that will enhance your life and will touch your soul. Come back next week. We've got another great show for you. Get out there and support local music and local art. And guess what? Until next week, bye.
A big boss man, can't you hear me when I call? Big boss man, can't you hear me when I call? Well, you ain't so big, you just talk, that's about all.